In this screencast, we're asked to determine how big an error do we make if we assume an ideal gas for water 150 degrees C and 0.1 megapascals. So the best value, of course, would be the steam tables. If we look in the steam tables, 150 degrees C, a tenth of a megapascal, we find that we're in the superheated region, meaning we're above saturation conditions, and the volume that we can read off the tables, this happens to be tables in the thermodynamics book by Elliott and Lear, but similar values can be found elsewhere. So the volume in cubic meters per kilogram. If we take instead and assume we have an ideal gas, 150 degrees C and a tenth of a megapascal, we calculate the volume. Let's call this volume ideal gas, and this is volume per mole. Of course, RT over P, the gas constant we're going to use for the units that we're interested in, cubic meters, pascals per moles, and Kelvin. The temperature, absolute temperature, 150 plus 273 Kelvin. The pressure, 0.1 megapascals. We need to do a units conversion, 10 to the 6 pascals per 1 megapascals. If I do the calculation, I get 0.035 17. This is cubic meters per mole. Okay, if we look at the units, so we have to do the conversion, 18 grams per mole, and then 10 to the third grams per kilogram. Now we have units of cubic meters per kilogram, 1.954 cubic meters per kilogram. So that's the value ideal gas, pretty close. Percent error would be the difference. Steam tables value minus the ideal gas value over the steam table value. These are all units of cubic meters per kilogram, so they cancel. And we want a percent, so multiply by 100, and I get 0.89%. negative. Less than 1% error by assuming ideal gas for superheated steam at these conditions. So ideal gas, pretty good approximation at these conditions.